Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm here with Ty from the Mono Loco Workshop. He came down from Arizona and he brought me a special gift. What did you bring, Ty?
I brought some Arizona bark scorpions.
These little scorpions are really tiny, but the venom that they inject when they sting you is so powerful that it'll cause severe pain in adults for up to 3 days. People who have been stung relate the experience to an electrical jolt.
Most people in Arizona get stung at least once in their lifetime, but this one right here is probably one of the most poisonous ones in America.
Ran over to my friend's house, caught about a jar full of them, and brought them over.
He's got them on ice, and why is that?
Well, they kind of hibernate during the winter time, and I've seen them come back alive after 3 months in the freezer.
I don't know, man. These guys look pretty knocked out. You think we can get them to come back to life?
I hope so.
There's like no movement whatsoever.
Still pretty cold for him, though.
All right, so check this out, guys. We got one of these scorpions out on a plate, and hopefully he doesn't spring back to life on us while we're working with him. But Ty's got a UV flashlight here, and you can see if you shine the flashlight onto the scorpion, you can see he just starts to glow. That is so cool. And apparently all scorpions, or at least most of them, will have some kind of a fluorescent characteristic about them.
Enough to creep you out.
What would creep me out is if he just like jumped up onto your face right now.
He'd creep me out too.
All right, there we go. I'm just gonna shove this guy into my hand. Hopefully he doesn't spring to life as I do. Oh, wow, that is insane. I feel like I'm seeing his leg moving. I don't know if that's just like a response from my hand or what, but if I tried to flick him off, he could really grab on hard, couldn't he?
Yeah, they've got some pretty good pinchers. They can hold on to the wall pretty good. They walk across the ceiling too.
Dang. Okay, I'm getting a little bit freaked out.
I swear I saw his leg moving.
And we're gonna add the rest of the family. It actually looks really cool.
So there's a cool random fact, guys. Scorpions glow under UV light. So if you live in a really hot, deserty area where you have scorpion problems, just grab one of these flashlights, take it out in your backyard at night, and light them up.
Oh, dude, that looks so sweet.
They'll start glowing when you expose them to black light or even natural moonlight, and the blue-green glow comes from a substance found in the hyaline layer, which is a very thin but super tough coating and a part of the scorpion's exoskeleton called the cuticle. Nobody really knows why scorpions glow the way they do, but because they do, it makes it really easy for us to find them. Go out at night when they're really, really active and just shine it around and they'll light up and stand out like a sore thumb.
Yeah, if you leave any boots outside or really in the garage or anywhere where scorpions can be, you want to shake out your pants, shake out your boots, shake out anything you don't want to get stung in.
Apparently these things will crawl into like really tight crevices. A 1/16 of an inch is all it needs. Yep. The cracks in your walls, the cracks in your doors.
If they want to be in your house, they will be.
They've got some weird little beady eyes on top of their head. They've got some black marks and maybe some other eyes on the front.
It's crazy how when the light hits them, they really do glow.
It's awesome. Well, it's kind of scary when you go out there and they just start running across the fence.
Oh yeah, I can imagine if these things were moving, if they were alive, that would be quite the show.
They don't seem to notice you unless you move something around them. So you can get right up on them, get a stick a half inch away from them, and then just get them.
And that is because scorpions have very bad eyesight. And so inside your house, they'll tend to crawl along the walls. If you want to catch them in your house, you can put some of those little glue traps down by the walls, and you'll have a better chance of catching them there.
Guys, our scorpions are officially dead. They are not moving, they are not coming back to life. So we thought it would be fun to maybe try one more experiment and put these things in a vacuum chamber just to see what would happen to them. This guy over here just made a vacuum chamber, this thing right here, and you can see how to make this on his channel.
It's not gonna hurt him at all, right?
They're already dead.
They're already dead.
So let's flip the switch, fire this thing up, and see what happens to a scorpion in a vacuum chamber.
See their abdomens protruding, but not enough to make them burst.
It kind of makes them a little more creepy.
All right, go ahead and release the pressure. Dang!
That right there is the stuff nightmares are made of.
You know what you should do is take some of these to that glow-in-the-dark laser tag. Put them on the walls in the laser tag arena.
He doesn't look much worse for wear, I mean, other than the fact that he's dead, but how crazy is that?
Looking at the carpet, can't really see anything. Shine a black light on it. Boom.
So if you find one of those in your house, it really stands out, doesn't it?
Yeah, as long as you have a black light.
Have you ever met anybody that got stung by one of these?
Mm-hmm. Quite a few people.
Oh, my 78-year-old neighbor told me that his whole leg was numb for a few days. I had people that told me that they got stung in the toe and they couldn't feel any of their toes for at least a day. My
sister-in-law got stolen, and she had to go get an anti-venom shot.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. What's interesting, as I move this light around, it almost seems like it's got a fluorescent paint on it. I mean, it almost doesn't look like it's part of the scorpion at all. It looks like it's just painted on. Very peculiar. The sides don't glow. And that's kind of why it looks like it's painted on. It looks like it just got airbrushed on the top and bottom. So let's take a look at that flashlight. Tell me a little bit about your flashlight, what it is.
This flashlight was probably only about $20. I think it's got 100 LEDs in it. Down in Arizona, you can pick these up at gas stations, Ace Hardware, really anywhere. The bigger ones, they're a little more costly, but these are the ones to get. I mean, you'll see a scorpion for 20, 30 feet away.
All right, cool guys, a fun little experiment, and we learned something new. Scorpions under black light will fluoresce. Not really glow in the dark scorpions, but fluorescent scorpions.
Get yourself a UV light, you can go out there, you can find them all, kill them all, you can protect your family, your friends, your neighbors.
It's almost like magic. So big thanks to my cousin Ty for making the trip out here from Arizona. He is the Mono Loco Workshop. He does all kinds of cool stuff with wood. If you want to see how his vacuum chamber works and how to assemble one yourself, you can go check that out on his channel. I'll put a link in the description below. Anyway, thanks for joining us for this video, guys. Hope you learned something new, and I'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. Bye.
Scorpion wins.
Fatality.